Bali. Not my cup of tea. Not my cup of tea. Vishal Bali.
Mr. Toastmaster and fellow Toastmasters, last August I completed my 10 year of stay in the United States. But it feels like yesterday, especially in terms of driving. Driving out here has never been my cup of tea. You have to follow so many rules. Driving was so much fun in India. You can jump the red light. You don't have to wait for a pedestrian to cross. You can change lane anytime you want. I really miss that flexibility here. No doubt, driving came as a big shock to me out here. I felt my world, I would like to say, my world turned upside down. But instead, it turned left side right. Yeah. Why? Because we drive on the left side of street in India. Getting license was very easy here. Because once you turn 25 years in Albuquerque, New Mexico, you don't have to take driving test or driving exam. Else, I'm sure I would have never received my driving license. To practice driving, I bought a used car with automatic transmission so that I don't have to worry about changing gears when I'm focusing on driving. To make my life even easier, I asked my Indian roommate to teach me how to drive. I did not take lessons from a driving school. Why? Because I did that in India and that was a complete waste of time and money. Also, my roommate was Indian, so it was easy for us to communicate and I could focus well while driving. During one of the practice sessions, my roommate, he told me to park my car in between two parked cars in a busy shopping lot. I was taking my own sweet time. And suddenly, I panicked. And instead of pushing brakes, I pushed gas pedal. And there I hit the car in the right. Boom! That car was badly damaged. My insurance shot through roof to fix the damaged car. Needless to say, I have to pay out of my own pocket to fix my damaged car. I felt really sad. My roommate tried to console me by saying that I think you need vision glasses that will help you see better while driving. Really? Well, not really. Every time I would drive for 3 miles, I would get stomach cramps. Oh. I promised to myself, I would never go on freeway. Even if that meant driving through inner streets, waiting at signals, wasting time, money, and gas. During one of the long weekends, my roommate and other friends made a plan to go to Vegas. But only two of us knew driving, myself and my roommate. I was not comfortable to drive, so I told my roommate, I'm not going to drive in the freeway. He said, you can drive at late night, there won't be any traffic. Oh, sounds good. But little did he tell me that there will be big trucks passing by every minute. Every time a big truck would pass by, I would swerve my car to the left. Number of times I heard, grrr, grrr. My poor roommate had to take driving back from me. Why? Because I was driving on the rumble strips. Also known as wake up call, alert light, sleeper light. Hang out the habit there, Else, I'm sure I would have driven somewhere in the woods. I had to come to Houston to start my PhD program, and there was no way I could have covered 800 miles using inner streets. So I had to force myself, go and drive the freeway now. I would go early in the morning and late in the afternoon to beat the rush hour traffic. I would drive for 3 exits and quickly turn. It took me 2 months of practice before I could drive on the freeway in Albuquerque. For your information, Albuquerque has a population of only 500,000. So their rush hour traffic is like regular traffic on 101. The worst part of the driving experience was once I hit Dallas downtown on a Friday evening at 4 p.m. It seemed a swarm of bees was attacking me from left, from right, from front, from back. Everybody was in a rush to reach home early. I just wanted to reach Houston. I was so scared, I peed a little bit mad. Let's be honest, driving is not my cup of tea. It is a necessary evil for me. I am getting better at it. LA is home condition was previous. But somehow I managed not to cause any accident yet. Well, life is a bumpy road and eventually we all learn how to ride on it. Thank you.